Hello, GCC. We are here to start chapter five, and I have a friend with me. Here's Bambi. She wanted to say hello. Hope everyone's doing good today. Go give your dogs and cats a pet for me. So, goodbye, Bambi. Anyway, this is going to be a short introductory video for a fairly long chapter. Chapter five builds on what we did in chapter four. So it's really important that you understand everything from chapter four before moving on to chapter five. We are going to talk about the atomic structure in this chapter. So more about protons, neutrons, and electrons to come. All right, first up is a scientist, Niels Bohr. Niels Bohr decided that electrons go around the nucleus of an atom back in 1913, so over 100 years ago. He said that these electrons orbit at distinct distances from the nucleus. The nucleus, again, is where the protons and the neutrons are located. So electrons are outside of that nucleus, going around and around and around and around really fast. And that they have distinct energies associated with them. So we say these orbits are called energy levels. So Bohr's model of the atom, the electrons orbit around the nucleus, kind of like the planets go around the sun, but it's in three dimensions. So you have to imagine like the nucleus is a marble, and then we have a baseball sphere around that marble, and the electrons can be on that baseball. Then we have a volleyball around it, and the electrons can be on that second level, which is the volleyball, and they can be on that surface and go around there. Then we have a beach ball. And so forth. So it's three dimensions. The orbits are called energy levels, or if you were in high school chemistry, they call them shells. But at the college level, we're going to call these orbits energy levels, these spheres where the electrons can exist. Each of these orbits or energy levels has a specific radius, meaning distance from the nucleus, and energy. So here's kind of a picture of what we're talking about. View this as a cross section. Again, this is like the balls that I was talking about that have been cut in half. So we see our marble nucleus in the middle, tiny little nucleus where the protons and neutrons are located. Then we see our first energy level. Here with my cursor, you can see the first energy level. There's an electron on it right there. So this is energy level one. And again, this is a cross section. So again, this is like a baseball around that marble nucleus. Then we have energy level two here. You can see with my cursor, energy level two. So that's our volleyball around the nucleus. And then we jump out to level three. That's our beach ball around the nucleus. Now, the orbit closest to the nucleus is lowest in energy. So that would be level one. The energy increases with distance from the nucleus. So energy level two is more energetic than one, and energy level three is more energetic than level two. These 3D orbits, again, are called energy levels. That's what we'll call them. And that's my introduction to the Bohr's model. See you in the next video. Thanks, GCC. Bye-bye.